Hello there. We are trying to make a celebration in Vampire the Masquerade 20th anniversary. We start off as Generation 13. I made this person a caregiver and want to help people, especially because they're one of the few vampire clans that have healing powers to others. And its demeanor, how it portray itself to others, is that it's judgmental, meaning that if you don't want to help people and not fight them, then she's going to be mad. And I'm going to make an Japanese girl is my plan. I have put only 2 points to begin with, because all of the Salubri's vampire abilities are driven upon perception and empathy, at least based on the three first dot of their abilities. So I think we will make a social girl, or maybe we should make an intelligent person. Yeah, I think we will do that. There's three ways of playing vampire, according to me. There is the XP based. You're trying to put the dots as maximum to save experience points later. Like saying you want to maximize your manipulation skill, and then only put 1 point in charisma. That's cheaper than cheaper to get five in all of your things if you have maximum one, if you maximize your stats as much as possible, but it makes you vulnerable to a lot of things later on. But I will come into that. Or else there is the balance. You try to put all your dots balanced on your character. Like if you have 5 points, you will put them like this is too many. 5 points you would put like this, right? And with all the others too. Or you can put them role-playing based, like this is a lying person, so you have a lot of manipulation instead. But we're going for the XP based, and if you want to make a difference, then you should do that. But Salubri should have a high perception. They are built to see things, because they have these vampire discipline aspects. They can see things that's not there, heighten their senses, see people's aura and so on. And this Obeha is the power of healing and protection, and see people's life, how well they are, and so on. So perception is important. And then we will make a smart Salubri. I made one before, and that was a social, so that's why I'm trying to change it to an intelligent one. Then we will make a person who can at least defend herself. She has the power to heal any damage, so we should maximize her stamina to she can take a lot of hits and don't have to use so much blood on healing herself at least. And then we will take actually strength 2, because we won't make her a fighter. Strength 2 is more than you can just so you can if one of your friends are knocked down, you have at least enough strength to drag them away from the fight and then begin to heal them. And then the social part, we want to manipulate people. We want them to understand what we are saying, like we have to heal them and listen to me and so on. So I think that would be a good start. Oh yeah, and the points are 753. Sorry, I should have started out with that. At the abilities, you have 13, 9, and 5. And I think we will make a stereotypically computer nerd crafter. So what we should have highest are, I actually think we have highest in to knowledge and then talent and then skill. To try something other than the other videos I have put up. Academics, she had been a lot in school. I had some education behind her. She good at computer, not too good with money. She can find stuff she's searching for. She know a little about the law, 8 point. Medicine, she could. That's not very important because she can heal, but if she wants to get someone up with a heart attack, she wants to use her healing powers to maybe try to get up if she can. Then she can fake she is giving heart massage and then not be caught being a vampire. And the medicine is just good to have if you want to heal people. I mean, it's good to see that the reason people are not standing up is not because they are hurt, but maybe they're sick. Occult, you should always take occult so you know a little about the magical world. You know if there exist mages, vampire, werewolf, fays, and spirits. And you know what myths are real and not basic. You know that vampire are not afraid of garlic and crosses and so on. So we have used 9, 10 points, we have 3 points left. And she is good with technology. I'm sorry if anyone feel offended, but that's how I will make her. Damn, Japanese to being so good at everything. Oh, they must hate it. You should also always take alertness, athletics. Alertness is what you see, and athletics is how well you are dodging and hitting with throwing weapons and jumping and stuff like that. Awareness, you should probably have something in awareness because you can see magical stuff. That's the ability to see magical stuff. I recommend you always take brawl so you can get loose from someone's grip. Empathy was already put there, so that you have to. That's your disciplines in your upper ear. I don't know how to pronounce it. Then we have 3 points left. You have streetwise 1, you can find around, and you can lie a little. I think. No, I actually think people should take leadership. We want to help people, we want to get people to together. Now we have 5 points. I think she has craft 3. We have only 5 points, so we have to be delicate with them. And she don't want to hurt anyone, she won't be good at that. Etiquette, she's respectful. And stealth, she can sneak around. That's always good to have. Then we have 3 points in disciplines. These can be a maximum of 5, these can be maximum of 3, these can be maximum of 3, backgrounds can be a maximum of 5, these can be a maximum of 5, and yes, I think that's good to go. Aspects is to heighten your senses, see things beyond what normal people can see. But there is a special salubri merit that makes this kind of obsolete. There's a few aspects ability that still can be used, actually a lot, but you know, the basic you can get this for free plus a few extra abilities. Fortitude is you can soak more damage and you can even soak fire and sunlight. And this is their special ability. That's the ability to see how well people are and how you can cure them. It's the ability to get people to fall asleep and remove pain from them. and it's the ability to heal, and that's at the 3-point mark. Then you can heal aggravated and lethal and bruised on vampires, mages, werewolf, normal human beings, and so on. So we want to take this. Also, for the abilities, you shouldn't take anything except for one in three. In my other videos, I explain why. So. But just trust me, you should only take one or three, not two. Background, we want to use a lot of blood, because we have to use a lot of blood when we're going to heal, and we're going to have a lot of blood in us to use it to heal. Generation, lower your generation here by 5 points to generation 8. You want it to be as low as possible, so you are as close to the original generation 1 vampires. And the closer you are, the more blood you have, and the more blood you can use. And that makes that we have 15 blood points to start. Some people want to roll a die to see how much to start with, but I will normally say that you probably have maxed out blood. Storyteller's discretion. And you can use 3 blood points a turn. Then we come to virtues. Conscience is if you want to do anything bad against innocent people, you have to roll dice equal to the dots you have to see if you lose generation. No, not generation, that would be OP. Humanity. And if your humanity reaches zero, you become consumed by the beast, and your character goes out of the game. And if you have it too high, you have to roll it constantly, because at 10 you cannot have a selfish thought and so on. But since we're not gonna hurt, and actually the opposite, conscience is not very important for us. Courage is, we won't be afraid. That would be bad to be afraid when we're about to heal people. And self-control would also be nice. So conscience and self-control makes your humanity, so we have 5 in humanity. And courage sets our willpower, so we have 5 willpower. These dots down here indicate how many willpower you have used to automatic successes. For example, you want to build something, that's intelligence craft, or someone say dex craft, depending on what you are building. But let's say intelligence craft, and you have to have 5 successes to make it, you have 7 dice, that's unlikely. So you use 1 willpower, and you only use 1 at turn, 1 per you know, 1 per turn, I think, or 1 per action, 1 per turn or 1 per action. You have 1 automatic success, you roll 7 dice to get 4 successes, and that's doable. Not easy, but doable. Down here I already set my flaws. Flaws you're not forced to take them, but they make character and gameplay, plus every point they give you can use to increase your points up here to make yourself stronger if you want to be able to resist more damage, or you want to be stronger, or whatever you want. So I have chosen 7 points, and this is from the Salubri clan book that makes them, they have a third eye in their forehead where they can see special things, and some of their abilities up here require them to open their third eye. But this flaw is that their normal eyes have a weird color. In modern days, not that frightening to have, but you know, in the Middle Ages, you have a weird eye color, you're probably a witch. But that actually gives you 2 points, so that's nice. New arrival, you just come to town, and you don't know anyone, that's 1 point. You stop them on 2 is also in the Salubri clan book. That makes that only if people are about to die and you cannot do anything, you can force yourself to run or something like that. There have to be a major reason why you cannot, and you can actually have it at free. Then it's like only if nothing actually. Maybe your GM would give you a reason still to run, but free is very high. One is like you have to argue if you lose. Short, you're not that high, so you run at half speed, and you are one of the few vampires that actually cannot like garlic for some reason. And then you can make. We have 7 points here, and I have used 5 of the 7 points to learn the merit only Salubris can learn. That's called Sight Beyond Sight, and that actually does makes all spaces not obsolete, but you don't need it for a long time. Sight Beyond Sight makes you open your third eye, and that makes you see through obfuscate, that makes people invisible. You can see through the shout, meaning you can see to the underworld. You can see through people's disguises. You can see people's aura. You can actually see through everything that's not real and see through dimensions and stuff like that. But you cannot control it, so you see what's, you know, most active, I guess, or the storyteller chooses. So it's like, you know, kind of a Malkavian ability to, you know, see the world for what it really is, but you're not crazy. Yeah, so that gives you us 2 points left, and you start with 15 points. If I just stand here, what you have to do? So you have like 17 points left. These cost 5 each dot, and not for each dot you have, but you know, 5 dots, you can put it one there or one there. These cost 2, these cost 7, these cost 1, these cost 2, and these cost 1. So I think we should have some willpower. People should not control us, and let's just max it. Then we have 12 points left. That makes us able to increase our intelligence to max. And then we have 7 points left. We could take Fortitude 1, and we can soak even more damage. I mean, you have 6 dice to prevent damage, and one of them can actually take sunlight and fire. I think that would be a good idea, and also gives, you know, a little bit. These cost 4 experience per dot you have when you gain experience through the game to take. So like this will cost 8 points to get the third. These cost 2 points per dot and 3 to start. These cost 10 dots to start and 5 per dot. And if you learn an ability that's not your clan ability, one of these 3, they cost 10 to start and 7 per dot. Background can be bought through gameplay, but they cost experience, as I recall. And these cost 2 experience per dot, willpower cost 1 per dot, and yeah, that's about it. You cannot buy merits later on, so you know, go through the list and see what you want. Flaws can be added if something in the story happens. Or maybe you can learn a few merits if you go GM decides or storyteller. Here you can write the weapons you start with, but we're probably not gonna start with any weapon. I don't think the storyteller would do that. So we are a 25-year-old Japanese person, and our appearance is very low, isn't it? We're not one of the beautiful Japanese people, are we? No. We are not. So we probably look older than we actually are, but okay. No, they are Japanese, the oldest look is younger. Oh damn. Birth is based on what year it is, based on when you died, you have black hair. You have eyes, violet, that's in the floor, I don't need to. Japanese, nation, USA, probably. Height, we are short, so we are like 150. Weight, we're going to play a girl, so I won't comment on that, and yes, the only thing we need is a name, and we're going to call her Tiki. For some reason, Magnus, and your sire is call whatever you want. I can't think of anything right now. Every attribute and ability you have at 4, you have to get a specialty, and the specialty makes that you, for example, intelligence is the keen edge mind. The description of them, there is no description of specialty, but keen edge mind is in the mage book. I don't know if it is in the vampire, but that we play in our group, that it doesn't give you any penalty for damage, or if you are tired, penalty for use intelligence based role like intelligence computer. That could be your specialty. Perception could be careful, so every time people are sneaking in on you and your storyteller tells you to roll your 10, if you roll a 10, it counts as 2 successes. And mostly it makes your 10s count for 2 if they uphold your specification. Like if you have careful and you try to see someone that is something far away, then your 10s won't count as 2. But if you have, you know, Farsight or Eagle Eye or something, that will count as 2. And for both craft and perception, all those. And if you have 2 that mixes, like you are creative and you have repair in craft, then if you find a creative way on repairing a car, then your 10s count as 3 successes. And yeah. That's about it, I think. I hope I haven't forgotten anything. I hope that helps you making a salubri. See you later.